The Shadow of the Dragon follows on from the previous game, but it is not a sequel. It really is an original story that is more based on the legends that have inspired Bram Stoker than Bram Stoker's book itself.
Those who play with Dracula III will find in The Shadow of the Dragon symbols such as secondary characters and details from the past adventure. Above all, what links both games is the interest for Vlad Tepes, the character who inspired Bram Stoker's Dracula.
Anyone who did not play with Dracula III can still totally enjoy this new adventure.
This is a whole new story that deals with the origins of the myth around Dracula. Who was he? How did he become a vampire? And can anyone or anything on Earth put him in the shade? The Shadow of the Dragon begins with the shipwreck of a freighter that carries an important art collection meant for the Metropolitan Museum. A few weeks later, one of the masterpieces is found in Hungary.
At this point, Ellen Cross steps in. She works for the Metropolitan Museum as an art restorer. She has little time left and finally, she completely enjoys the last moments of her life through this adventure.
Helen does not suspect that this apparently simple mission is about to take her throughout Europe on the steps of a vanished portrait that might be that of the Lachesis prince, the famous Vlad Tepes. The heroine, Helen Cross, is a strong young woman affected by a very severe orphan disease since she's a little girl. This disease built her character.
She has been hiding this disease to everyone, which allows her to keep the best tasks or else she would be assigned to lower tasks. This way, she can take part in adventures and enjoy her passion, restoring masterpieces.
We try to bring out this energy and passion on her appearance.
She is natural, she is elegant, but not sophisticated. She has short hair because it's more convenient. But above all, she's a woman of character.
The player will encounter a large variety of characters. For instance, one of her main allies is Adam Stoker, Bram Stoker's imaginary grandson. Dracula's fans will surely recognize through Friedland, the character of Renfield, the asylum inmate in Dracula after whom a psychotic syndrome was named. The Shadow of the Dragon is particularly adapted for exploration and immersion. The adventure is based on a scenario, of course, but there are several optional interactive action sets that allow the players to go into the character's background in depth, as well as into the origins of Dracula.
The lock is jammed.
It's really a game for all audiences.
This game does not require a lot of dexterity or swiftness, but some reflection and observation.
Several difficulty levels are available, so casual gamers and even beginners can enjoy the adventure.